Be sober, be vigilant. Be sober, be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Whom resisteth first in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions I accomplish in your brethren that are in the world. This is a word of words of caution, advice of caution that God through Peter spoke and is still speaking to us. Because of the influence of Satan into this world has become a dangerous world. God created this world to be peaceful. God created this world to be a world where we will love ourselves, where we will communicate with ourselves, where we will commune with ourselves in harmony. Yeah. The Bible said he is the God also that commune within himself. He commune with himself. He showed us and talked about Trinity, about relationship. So we are the God, the Father, the God, the Son, the God, the Holy Spirit, who are distinct, and yet they are one. Amen. Can you still bring it down a little bit? I don't want to sound too shouty. Amen. The Bible said, because of whom God has made us to be, demons, the angels, the Satan, was proud, filled with pride, and he lift up himself in his thinking, and he said, I want to be like God. So he was thrown down to this earth, and because he was thrown down to the earth, he looked at the beautiful things that God has given unto us. He wanted to have it for himself. So he deceived Eve, and Eve ate from the apple, from the forbidden fruit, and gave to the husband, and sin entered into this world. Therefore, hatred, crime, murder entered into the world. Amen. So God said, be sober, be conscious, be vigilant. Even though you have known enough about the love of God, about the passion of God, you have beginning to see the power of God and his greatness, the glory of God. But be conscious. God, because he loves us, always likes to let us know what we should be doing, what we should be aware of, what we need to know. He didn't assume that we know about Satan. He didn't assume that we know about his trickish ways. He don't want to assume, because he knows that on this earth we are growing in knowledge. We are growing in understanding. We are growing in the way that we apply wisdom. And we need to be reminded every day. We need to be reminded every time about the plans of God, about his mind. If we want to confront the adversary, if we want to confront Satan the devil, if we want to make sure that our life will fulfill the purpose of which we were created, then we need to listen to the one who has written everything himself, who is the creator. Especially we that we are in the Western world, now that we are living here in Africa, there's a lot of hunger and there's a lot of money. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, we are very rich and we are very hungry. This is really something paradox. It's opposite each other. The same Nigeria where you find the richest Dangote
in Africa,
and so many of them, that same country, people are living beyond sense in a day. And then you see people are trooping to churches because of hunger, because of fear, lack of security, lack of light. Somebody can come and knock your door and say, bring everything that you have that you don't even have. They dare not go to the rich man's place who are stealing from the purse of the country. They don't have enough. strength, enough confidence, enough boldness to go and knock their houses because other poor people are around as may guard. They are around as security agent, guiding the one who is actually stealing. Come, am I talking Africans?
Well.
But now we come to a place of comfort. A place where we can sleep and nobody is disturbing us except those who are calling us to bring money from Africa. That is the ending that we have here. Nobody will come and knock your door and say that bring all your money, I want to rob you. Nobody will bring gun and say that I want to shoot you. I mean, you got all your wife, they will kill you, you got a dust pattern. Amen. Yeah, it's beginning to happen now in Austria. The other day I launched Kilburger. Oh, where was it? Somebody out of jealousy. The guy said, I go gray. Shot the man, shot the girl, shot the father, shot the mother, shot the sister and kill himself. Just because family, wipe off the whole family. Because guy no gray. Hi. Hi, my. Oh! Law full everywhere. Somebody will kill himself for nothing. Well, let me continue my talk. Amen. We need to be sober. We need to be vigilant. We cannot say because we are not here. Look at us. We are here. We have the comfort. We are supposed to be the best worshippers of God. The best people that will be able to apply the wisdom of God. We are supposed to be the best people that will be able to kneel down and pray. Just pray 5 minutes prayer and God is answering. But then we allow ourselves to be overtaken with the stress. Those people they go and do night vigil just for you to send 100 euro and you are running letters scattered to kill yourself to send the 100 euro. If you are also prayerful, you will know and discern that you don't need to send 100 euro, 500 euro to somebody who will be using the latest phone while you are using old phone. You will use which model? Which year be that one? Praise the Lord. This man that is on the camera does not even have telephone. This is telephone, eh? I don't know which year that telephone is produced. Amen. But can you imagine us killing ourselves, doing 2 jobs, doing 3 jobs, working in Tascata? We don't even have time for God to satisfy somebody who is not doing anything but is always going to church. To fast and pray, to twist your head. Man, I know vessel. Those are going to listen to me from Nigeria. Because we are now all over the place through Facebook. But that is the truth. When we look in yourself or somebody, be vigilant. These are the little devils that we have. Nobody will come to knock your door to rob you. Nobody will come to say this or that. Even the witchcraft powers are limited. Because there are some things that the fact that you are in Oyibo land alone will suppress their power. It's not as if they are not here, oh, because they're full here too. Oh, will suppress their organ. Because that side, Nepa is like the place is dark. That one will create one fear on its own. But here you will own your life 24 hours. You will be able to see kuro what is happening. Do you understand what I'm saying? Be vigilant, be sober. Satan is a roaring lion. Walk about seeking who he may devour. And that is what the Bible says, resist him, steadfast in faith. Resist him, steadfast in faith. It's a continuous resistance that you need to gain with knowledge, that you need to gain through understanding. Through understanding of the word of God, through understanding of who you are yourself, to be able to evaluate yourself and to be able to know your own value, to be able to evaluate yourself and to be able to know your own standard. God even help us for us to know ourselves, for us to know the grade that he has placed us. Why? So that we will know how to talk to anything that wants to bring us down. Amen. We run it and scatter here. We are looking for visas. We are looking for passport. We are looking for this and that. We concentrate on ourselves on the things that are not actually. Tu restes important. There are necessities, but not that important. Into control our day-to-day life. That need, that urge should not control our day-to-day activity. The only control it should have is the control of going to those courses. Am I talking?
Yes.
Instead of sitting down in hand, waiting for only that change that they will give you. By the time they give you the change, you will send the change to somebody who has been fasting and praying for favor. And you make yourself a victim. Then you send the money. Tomorrow you are hungry again. You are crying again. You are just, because of visa, you won't be able to face Dutch. They say, come and learn Dutch in the school. Your brain is full. Why? Dutch, you don't feel it. Why? They bombard you from home. Now, when you are strong in the Lord and in the power of His might, when you are sober and when you are vigilant, when you are praying, when you are able to resist, you will know the things that are important to you and to do them first. I was so happy when my sister, what is her name? Mrs. Cook. Though she's a graduate, a master degree graduate from University of Innsbruck here. She did a subject of English. She said when I preached that Dutch is very important to communicate, she went to register for Dutch course. She was not there saying they take me preach. She was so happy and saw the sense in the master degree order, the sense. So that if she will not get a job, with what she has studied, she can get a job. But the understanding of the necessity of the language to communicate, the necessity of integration entered into her brain. And then she went to register. Because you must integrate. Amen. After all, our simple adage says something. If you are in Rome, do what? You don't talk about yourself. So when we are here, we need to integrate. All these are the things that we should be pursuing. Not that somebody will be giving us headache, who is now an adversary to your progress and our progress, and then you are there lying down in the house, so much worried that your mama or your papa or your sister or your brother is not getting one thing or the other. In their difficulty, they have been able to manage and to know how to move forward. Amen.
Amen.
Now the Bible said that you should know who you are. Resist in faith, meaning gather the word of God. Know the word of God very well so that you can answer the enemy. Let me now start doing it. 1 Peter 2:9 said, but you are. 1 Peter 2:9. Do you know who you are? You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people. You are called so that you can show forth the praises of Him who has called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. The plans of God for you and I is that we are a light that shines brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. God said, I have chosen you. Not only have I chosen you, you are a king. I have made you, I have put a cloth of royalty upon you. He said, you are a royal priesthood, a kingly priest. What do priests do? Priests, they offer sacrifices unto God. Priests, they offer themselves as a living sacrifice unto God. They are an intermediary person between God and man. That is why Jesus is our high priest. Is somebody listening to me? I want you to know that you are a chosen generation. God has chosen you. He has chosen you to represent Him on this earth. He has chosen you as a king, so you are not a non-entity. He has chosen you as a priest, so you are a representative of other people. Are you hearing what I've just said?
Yes,
I don't say don't take care of them at all. I said, maybe they're careful, you. because we cannot really rule it out. But you don't kill yourself for what you shouldn't kill yourself for. Are you Jesus? I mean, I send money home to my mom every month. It's her salary. My mom must eat. She's 80 something years old. Send money to her regularly. She doesn't need to ask me. You should have not spoken to my mom for the past 6 months or 8 months. But she gets her money every month. Because where she is, the internet connection is, you call her, and I tell her, one day for a bush, don't go inside farm. But it's a thing of her conscience. I must send something to her. But if I don't have, I must not. Anyway. But it's an obligation I keep. But you see all those my sisters and my brothers, don't be born there. Maybe they hear now, they will shout for home, say, hey, I was better, you better. Amen? I speak my language to them so that we're better. Amen. They are married. They have houses. And then you will get calling. Hey, auntie, I want to greet you. I my business is down there. When you sell money, how many times I will sell you money when you do your business? Who does sell money when I tell you my own business for you? They bump again, I go send money to them. Maybe they take care of Piki. Congratulations. That they do marriage, I send money to them. Congratulations. Abi? But no, you see, you just treat me anyhow. Meanwhile, they say, I never even build finish. You don't build that many. You understand what I mean?
Yes, sir.
Know your family. It is called be vigilant. That is what God is telling us. Be vigilant. Don't be mumurish. Then you go home, they see you, they see you, and so you be finished. You don't pass this one. See the clothes that they wear. Because the one where they put for hand, the shirt where they are neck. Eh? Now original. You they wear shanare ready for Ebola. Do you understand what I'm telling you? You are managing driving a car. Eh? A whole car. Then they are driving brand new and they pay their own car. But you there yet, your car is basic. My own too now basic. Before I finish paying my new car, now four years time, 1 year I don't pass, and they can't have every month. But then when they buy their own, I cash down.
I cash down and carry same
chair. I hope you understand what I'm saying. I'm not saying don't help, but be vigilant. Because these things, they are our adversaries. That is destroying us in Europe. That is giving us unnecessary stress. That we are running around. That is why somebody will just stand. Boom, you will fall. And nobody is there. That is the end. Dying for who? Be vigilant. So your adversary here is not the witches and the witchcraft that is pressing people in Africa that are putting juju on the way. That will be calling one person's name in order. These are the little ways that the adversary comes to destroy us. Envy, bitterness, unforgiveness. But remember who you are so that you can be able to look at all those things. You don't allow them to touch you. Amen.
Amen.
You are a chosen generation. You are a peculiar person. You are very special. You are very special. Nehemiah too. You are very special. The Bible tells us about Nehemiah. When they wanted to build a wall, the enemy, they destroyed the walls of Jerusalem. And Nehemiah, they went. Nehemiah was sent back to go to Jerusalem to build the walls of Jerusalem. And the Bible said Nehemiah 2:18. From 18. The Bible says when they were building, adversaries came against them. As you are progressing in life, I know people, some people don't like you. Some don't like you. It's very rare for people. That is why God said, be sober, be vigilant. At the same time, you have to be full with knowledge and wisdom and understanding. It's not as if somebody cough near you, you already call the person witch. No. Have a spiritual eyesight to be able to see. The Bible said that Nehemiah was building the wall, and then Simbalant and Tobiah, they came against him. Can you see yourself that you want to attempt, have a project, you want to attempt, open a company? Is it wrong for you to open a company here?
No.
I mean, I would be very happy seeing this for African brothers and sisters, opening good companies here, doing something great. It's going to be my joy to see some of you being able to employ other Africans and people. It's my joy. Why not? But do you know that at times when you want to start such kind of projects, you want to start opening, you have an idea, and you are sharing it with a brother and a sister, and you say, oh, look at this idea. I believe I have already done the feasibility study of Innsbruck. I have already done the feasibility study of Tirol. I know very well, and I am sure, not because I've even seen somebody else done it, but because in the place of prayer, the idea has been given to me, and I really search. There is nobody that is running this kind of business, and I want to do it. Am I talking?
Yes, sir.
Then you will see there are some Sabalat and some Topia that will come. And then they will say, see, he told them, he said, then I told them of the hand of my God, which has been good upon me, and as also the king's words that he has spoken unto me. And they said, let us rise up and build. So they strengthened their hands for this good work. Can we see 19, please? But when Sabalat and Horonite and Topia the servant, the Ammonite and the Geshen, the Arabia, heard it, they laughed us to scorn and despised us and said, what is this thing that you do? Will you rebel against the king? Then I said, I then. Will you reply the devil?
Yes, sir.
Will you reply the devil?
Yes, sir.
When you want to do your business, somebody will tell you, say, it will go work. This is not Nigeria. This is Tirol. This is Oyibo land. This is Innsbruck. This is not Abia. This is not Umuahia. This is not Isha. Don't believe you there. Don't be Lagos. So let me tell you very well, it will not work. This is, these people, they don't like anybody to rise up. You see the Austrians, they will never want you to rise up. So don't just try this business. You will see somebody telling you like that. But you know that God has told you to start something. You know that God has asked you to invest. This is where your faith needs to be steadfast. This is where your faith needs to be stronger. Why? Because God has spoken to you. Because God said, anywhere you set your feet, it is for your possession. Because God said that you are her light that shines brighter and brighter until the perfect day. Because God said to you that you are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar person who has been called out of the darkness of people that are lying against you, of people that reject you, of people that neglect you, and you have been taken out of that darkness. Of people that want to talk you down, you have been taken out of that darkness. Of people that want to oppress and suppress you, you have been taken out of that darkness. And the Bible says you have been translated, you have been transferred, you have now been put into his marvelous light.
Amen.
And you in that light, you open your mouth and give a reply. Yes, you said I'm not going to make it. Yes, you are telling me, trying to discourage me. You not discourage me so that you don't have courage. You want to discourage me in things that I am going to do. But then you have to resist that person in faith. Because faith is the substance of things hoped for. Evidence of things not seen. You have the substance, you know it is going to be well. You have your substance, you know you have seen from God. Otherwise you will not get that idea. And then you need to answer, you have to say unto them, the God of heaven. Somebody say the God of heaven.
The
God of heaven. He will prosper us. He will prosper me. Therefore, I will arise. I will go forward into this plan. But you, that you are my adversary, that you are talking me down, you will have no portion in it. Nor will you have right, nor will your memorial for this Israel where we dey. You say they no go know me. You say make I not do the business. You say make I not move forward. For this Israel that we are, don't worry. For this Israel, nobody will know you. But me, I will shine. Now they're right there now. Hallelujah! Sir, he said no memorial in Jerusalem. I will continue in the plans of God for my life. I will serve God wholeheartedly. You say going to church is rubbish. No problem. I will go to church and serve God wholeheartedly because the word of God is the mirror where I see myself. The word of God is that mirror, that place where I'm able to see what is written about me. The word of God gives me hope. I will continue studying the word of God and by his grace continue following the word of God. But you that you mock me and you reproach me, don't worry. In your presence, I will shine. And you, nobody will know you.
Amen.
I thought somebody will shout
Amen.
Me. Are you afraid to say it? Tell your neighbor on your left and your right. Tell my neighbor. Look at me very well. Because of this word that I've had today, I'm recharging again. I'm recharging again. I want to do something new. If you like, not support me, oh. But for your presence, I go rise. I go shine. I go make up. Abuse them. But the Bible said the memorial of them that reproach you shall not be found. Let us close. That is why we need to know how to pray. The Bible said Jesus was always praying. Praise the Lord. The Bible said Jesus was always praying. But Jesus was the Son of God. Jesus was God himself. Why does he need to pray? Did you hear what I just said? Jesus is the Son of God. The Bible tells us that Jesus is God himself. And if you look at the book of Mark 1, I think 18 or so, let me check my Bible. Hallelujah. Amen. Mark 1:35. It says, and in the morning, rising up a great while before day, Jesus went out and departed into a solitary place and there prayed. Matthew 14:23 says, and when he had sent the multitude away, he went up into the mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. Don't worry. Luke 6:12 repeated the same thing. He said, and it came to pass in those days that he went out into a mountain to pray and continued all night prayer to God. Tell somebody you need God. Tell somebody you must pray. Tell somebody prayer is the key. Tell somebody prayer is the answer. Do you know that God said that the angels are our ministry servants? In the book of Hebrews, the angels are our ministry servants. And do you know how you sent them to error? The Bible tells me in the book of Daniel that Daniel was praying. And while he was praying, angel Gabriel was sent to him. Not when he was singing, not when he was dancing, not when he was giving offering. When he was praying, angel Gabriel was sent to him to give him the answer to the prayer. The devil came and the devil resisted him. When I behold this boy, why you know they look? And this is my evangelist who I get to. Over, you want to preach? Hallelujah. Be high too. Ah? Be high see. Nima. Aha. Nima wants to be an evangelist. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Bible said that Daniel was praying. I have only 5 minutes now, then we'll go for our program. The Bible said that Daniel was praying. Who was sent to give the answer? A gentle prayer. And because he didn't get the answer, he continued praying. Who was sent to assist him so that he would get the answer? The archangel Michael. Jesus knew, and every other apostles knew, and all the prophets of the world, they know that when you pray, the angels will be released on your behalf. When you are praising God, God himself come and take over the situation. So Jesus knows that anytime he's on this earth, he must pray, because it is with prayer that he can invite and call the angels to minister on his behalf. So one way you can reply the devil is for you to engage in prayer. Because as you engage in prayers, the angels will go before you and will make every crooked path to become straight. And that is why the word of God said, no weapon fashioned against us shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against me in judgment, I shall condemn. It is not any other person that can condemn me, it is you. And through prayer, you are able to reply the devil. You are able to condemn the works of the enemy. You are able to destroy the plans of the evil one. You are able to call the goodness of God to become in your life. You are able to call the blessings of God to happen in your life. You are able to start a project and you are able to finish the project. You are able to start a plan and you are able to finish the plan. It was through prayer that Nehemiah stood and he was able to build the wall. And whatever Sanballat and Tobiah and the other ones that we are talking against him, he did not allow it to shake him. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And through prayer, you are able to exercise and to put your faith into practice. Elijah was a man like you. He prayed earnestly and he asked the rain not to fall for a time of 3.5 years, and the rain did not fall. Elijah, a man like you, prayed again and rain started falling.
Amen.
As much as you gather knowledge of who you are, a priest is an intercessor, and you are a royal priesthood. That is where Jesus prayed, because he is our high priest. You have to learn and to know how to pray. Don't take things for granted. Don't take Christianity for granted. Don't think that because you are in Europe, you cannot go to church early. You should thank God that you are able to come to church easily, not like in Nigeria. You should be able to praise God and appreciate Him. They wake up early in the morning. Fear drives them into the church. Fear of not knowing what. Most of them, it's not because they have a relationship with God, they don't have fear. Hunger, poverty. But you that God has blessed. I mean, we know that the money of Europe and Europe. When you tell them at home, they don't understand that. When you tell them that you earn salary of 1,250 euro or 1,300 and you are using 800 to 900 to pay for your house rent, they think you are nuts, you are a liar. But that is the life you are living here. How much is your bill? How much is your house rent? If you are living in one room, 500 euros. You work and the money you earn enters this place. It's like a Colombo. The money of Lagos remains in Lagos. So for you to send 50 euro, they don't understand. That you have to make yourself hungry. For you to send 100 euro, they don't understand. That you have to make yourself go hungry because you must pay house rent of 800 euro. some of us, our house rent is above 1,000. That is why husband must work, wife must work. Otherwise, no food in the house. Yes. We don't even have time to take care of our children the way we need to take care of our children. Why? You must work. Husband must work. Wife must work. Who is staying at home? Then in between, you are rushing to come and have time for your children. In between. I mean, I remember when my children were so young. Daddy, we come back from work 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, I'm already in McDonald's. And we walk till midnight. Just for me to have time for the children in the morning, I have to go for a night walk. Otherwise, it's not possible. Early in the morning, daddy is gone. He doesn't see his children. By the time he comes back, the children are already almost time to go and sleep. Weekend, because he has one family, he will start looking for a car. Not having time for the children, he will start looking for a car. And they talk and they talk to now because I know who know the time this one I go marry. No, the important people here today now. Amen. This young boy that we are going to dedicate today, please have time for me. I beg you. I beg you, Julius. I beg you, Sarah. This child that you are having and other children you are going to have time for them. Please. Don't allow the busyness of Europe to rob you of the care of that relationship that you will have with your children. You can't get it tomorrow. What you don't start now with this child, I'm so happy the way he's carrying this child. It shows the closeness and the nearness. If you don't start it now to take care and be close, tomorrow they will run away from you. They will not confide in talking to you. Difficult for my children to talk to daddy. Because daddy was always working. Daddy did not have time. The only time he will have time is to give instruction. You know? If they are gone. Don't do that again! Come back here! Do that! But he doesn't beat, he has never raised up his hand against any of our children. But if he shouts, you go shake for where you did. Even me, why is that? Stop or pass, stop on this. If he shout, I go with you. I go do like this. So that makes them. And now that he wants the closeness, it's difficult. And this is what I notice in my own home. It's difficult. They can always come and wrap themselves around me. As old as they are, they can give me pussy because I'm always giving them pussy. If I write them myself, blessing was up, I must send pussy to them. I must send love sign to them, and they must send about to you. Now me and them. So it's easy for them to open up. But I'm not a man. And I can't train men like a woman. You understand what I mean? So they now are struggling to have a relationship which was not possible because of struggling to make it in Europe. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So please, you that you are starting your family now, don't struggle to make it in Europe. Or struggle because you want to build one house at home, you want to build two houses. I mean, investment is very good. But don't neglect the very important thing. Your family is more important. For the two of you, because I don't want you to be that struggle. I know. When I see this, my daughter, she takes it because she like make yourself shine and do something. Bow down, no. This is not a marriage program, but I will talk. Bow down, no. No kiri, no karakara. This is your crown. Bow down. I have support him to take care of your family. You will enjoy yourself in the future. If you want to compete with him, you're in trouble. As I still there yet tomorrow. If I want to send money, let me work the money. I mean, collect the salary, I see they take permission. I'm not a fool. To send money to my mama, to send to your brother. Daddy, make I say now, sister, funny, you know there yet? Something happened last week. They canceled my permission. I come now, do out. They canceled the permission. I canceled the thing. I said, I make no first. You have to. The mind is the head. For your children to grow in the way of God, the man is your spiritual. No matter how much of the Bible you know, submit. Amen. he enjoyed himself. And I trust him. Don't disgrace with my daughter. I'll come down house one Friday. You know me. So if you know, say I stop on school. I go tie my wrapper for waist. Hold this. But I do the same thing. I go tie her wrapper for waist. Come fight you. So take care of my daughter. May the Lord bless you all. As you pick little wisdom and knowledge from everything that I have said, you will shine. And in every situation, you will know how to reply to people. Be positive in your mindset. Be positive about your plans. Know that God is with you. Ask always for his support. Submit yourself unto him. Let faith be in you. Have confidence that you are able to make it, that you cannot fail. Have confidence that your mind will tell you the right thing to do. And God will help you, and you will make it in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless you so they were.